I know that we all love a good series of omnibuses, whether it goes on for 3, 4, maybe even 5 volumes, but today we're going to focus on the one and done books and which one is the best. Woof woof! Hey guys, it's me Marcus, aka the Mad Dog, and we're back with another video. I've been thinking about doing this video for a while because I often get asked what I think is the best omnibus for new readers, whether that be from Marvel or DC. And admittedly, for somebody who's new to this hobby, I don't think that they're going to want to buy 4 volumes of a book that costs $125 at cover price. Because it's the internet, I do have to throw out this disclaimer, but this is based entirely on my opinion. So if you're expecting this list to be a copy and paste of what your own list would be, I'd recommend making your own video because that's probably the only way that that's going to happen. We're just going to start with number 10, which for me is going to be Deadpool and Cable. I know when it was originally being printed, it was Cable and Deadpool, but that's what it says on the book, so obviously I'm going to say it that way here. I read this in the 3 complete collections that came out quite a few years ago, and then it upgraded to the omnibus, which is why it's still sealed. I think I read this at the perfect time as well, which is something that I feel like a lot of people don't actually acknowledge, that the time when you read a book can also factor into the way that you view it. This was before the Deadpool movie came out, and I felt like it hadn't reached that saturation point with the character, but also I just really like Cable's design. There's so many different story arcs in here that I feel like, yeah, there was a bit of a lull in the middle, but it really picked up as it kept going on, so I enjoyed new enough every moment that I had with this book. The artists stand out throughout, and I think that if you were a new reader and you wanted something Deadpool, this would be the book that I'd recommend you. This was my main Deadpool book. Number 9 are what I feel is a very, very underrated and often forgotten run, but it's Fantastic Four by Mark Waid. Again, this is another one that I read the complete collections of. I've got them by my feet because I haven't managed to sell them yet. The Fantastic Four is a team that I feel like has just been forgotten and neglected for the last couple of years. Yes, obviously you've got Dan Slott writing it at the moment, but that isn't really getting that much hype. I feel like this book could change that impression for quite a lot of people, so if you haven't read this book already, it's definitely one that I'd recommend picking up. The stories in it are just really enjoyable, really family-friendly fun. Admittedly, there was a bit of a weird moment with the Thing in it, which I'm not going to spoil here, but if you've read it, you probably know which one I'm talking about. But the art in it is great throughout, and it's got a great level of detail whilst also having a cartoony aspect to it. And Mark Waid just seemed to really understand exactly who these characters are, and it came through when he was telling this story. Number 8 is a book that had so much hype about it when it was coming out in single issues, but then the creator went on to do something even bigger than that, to the point where it seems like this one got forgotten, and it's Runaways by Brian K. Vaughan. Because I picked this up as a result of reading Why the Last Man, and that is one of my favourite titles of all time, and this, even though it isn't that same high standard as Why the Last Man, it's still really enjoyable throughout. I kind of wish that the TV show would have done better, because then maybe this would have been more popular as well, but I still love what we got here. And this is something that I do have to bring up, because the Runaways obviously did continue, especially as a result of how well this did in single issues. But for me, this is a one and done omnibus because of the fact that you can read this and you don't need to read any more. It's a great coming of age story, and I think the time in which I read it, because obviously I was a teenager at the same time and I was going through that bit of a rebellious phase, which for me wasn't really that rebellious at all. I think the most rebellious that I got was that I kicked a bin once and almost broke my foot, so I'm probably not the good barometer on being rebellious. But I've got such fond memories with this book, and Brian K. Vaughan is one of those writers that you just hear his name and you know that you're in for a good time. And I think between Why the Last Man and Saga, Paper Girls and Ex Machina, Runaways is unfortunately the one that often gets forgotten about. My number 7 pick is probably more nostalgia than anything, but it's The Ultimates Omnibus by Mark Millar. Again though, what happened to this guy? Like 10 years ago, he was the biggest name in comics, but you don't really hear from him anymore. But yeah, I had to upgrade to the omnibus for this one because of the fact that my original trade paperbacks were pretty much falling apart, but The Ultimates was my universe. This was how I got into comics. Between this, Ultimate X-Men, Ultimate Spider-Man, and Ultimate Fantastic Four, if it wasn't for those titles, I don't know if I would have got into comics at all. So know that a lot of people in the generations before mine shit on The Ultimates because it's not the main Avengers, but for me, this is just great storytelling. It's the Avengers for a modern audience, and yeah, I don't really think that they stick the landing with absolutely every character that they re-envisioned. Like, Bruce Banner became more like the enemy of the team than he was a member of it. You can't deny as well that the art is absolutely fucking beautiful from Brian Hitch. Yeah, I know that there was an Ultimates 3, but for me, all you need is this book. You've pretty much got all the Ultimates that you need right here. Number 6, and I feel like this book would be much higher for other people, but for me, it's going to be Thor by Walter Simonson. This is a great Thor story, and yes, I can see now why this was so influential on the character. And because the art is a little bit more blocky, I didn't know if I was going to enjoy it that much, but as I got into the book, I really started to fall in love with it. I know some people don't like the recoloring. I can't really do anything about that. But because this was how I was introduced to this series, I remember reading this in a very quick time, considering how whammy of a boy this is. You've got all the Beta Ray Bill stuff, you've got Throg, you've got great storylines with Odin, and there's just so much in here that if you're a fan of Thor, or maybe you're trying to become a fan of Thor, near enough everything that is to love about this character is going to be in this book at some point. So I have to recommend it. I bought it on the back of, I think it was Thor Ragnarok, and I read it shortly after that, and I just really enjoyed the time that I spent with this book. Now, before we jump into my top 5, I'd just like to ask you that if you're enjoying this video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you're new here, why not click that subscribe button and the bell notification next to it so that you can make sure that you never miss a video. Number 5, and some people might disagree with me putting this as a one and done book, but it's Planet Hulk. For me though, even though you see at the end that he's clearly going back to Earth, and which leads into it being World War Hulk, this is all that you need. If anything, I'd recommend that you don't read World War Hulk. The art is pretty bad from John Romita Jr. The story pretty much just doesn't do as much as it does here. This book developed the Hulk. It allowed us to spend time with him where he wasn't treated as just a monster like he is on Earth. He starts off as a gladiator. You see him working his way through the ranks, and you see him ending up becoming some kind of conqueror. In a weird way, this entire book felt like some kind of what if story, but it's got great emotional depth, which I really wasn't expecting. It's an event comic that somehow stayed contained to itself, so it didn't really affect the wider Marvel universe until he came back to Earth. And considering that this story arc only lasted for about 2 years, it just did so much. There's so many enjoyable moments with this. There's also galactic characters that appear throughout it that'll take you by surprise. Great action, great storytelling, and also quite a heartbreaking ending that I feel like most people who have heard about Planet Hulk but maybe not read it should do themselves a favor, because this is one of the best reads that I had when I think I read it in about 2018. Now, my top 4 kept interchanging for quite a bit whilst I was thinking about this list, but I ended up settling on The Punisher Max by Jason Aaron. Fuck me, what a good book. I think I've read this 2 times already, and it's just great start to finish. Jason Aaron and The Punisher is like the perfect combination, and I also think that this might be my favourite Jason Aaron book of all time. Now, admittedly, there are parts of this book where it does feel like they crossed out the name Daredevil and put The Punisher in instead, because you see him going up against the Daredevil's rogues gallery quite a lot of the time. But that was one of the things that really took me by surprise and that I really enjoyed, because you get to see him go against a different enemy set than what he's usually used to. I think as well, if you were to put a gun to my head, which I'd thank you to not to, this might actually be my favourite Punisher omnibus of all time. I recently read the Marvel Knights run, and all it made me want to do was read this one again, so that says a lot about this book, and I think that it's something that even though it's out of print, everybody should have this in the collection, whether you're a Punisher fan or not, because this just does so much good stuff. It's just a great action book from beginning to end. Number 3, and I'm going to have to cheat on 2 fronts with this one, because it's Darth Vader by Kieran Gillen. The first way that I'm cheating is because I'm a peasant and I've only got the oversized hardcovers, and secondly, I don't know if anything Star Wars can really be one and done, because of the fact that this takes place between episodes 4 and 5, and also it does tie in with the main Star Wars run by Jason Aaron. But for me, because of the fact that you do get those Star Wars issues that you do need to read for the crossover, this is a one and done omnibus, and if they ever did print it, I'd be tempted to upgrade to it just because of how much I enjoyed this book. More than just a Darth Vader story, it's a tale about a man who has lost everything and is trying to prove himself in a universe that doubts him. And that's when Darth Vader's at his absolute most dangerous, and you can tell it from issue 1 in this book that he really isn't here to fuck around. The art as well by Salvador LaRocca deserves some praise as well, because it really gave it that film quality to it, because he's got a photorealistic style. And I wish that every series that he was involved in would be in an omnibus, like Invincible Iron Man by Matt Fraction. Are you listening, Marvel? Nah, they're probably not. So yeah, even though I am cheating with the oversized hardcovers, the omnibus for this run is one of the best one and done Marvel stories that has probably ever been printed, and I've heard that the sequel series by Charles Soule, which, you know, still doesn't affect this being a one and done book, is apparently even better than the Kieran Gillen run. Number 2, and before you dislike the video, even though you might have already done it by this point anyway, just hear me out, because it's gonna be Alias. Yes, I've only got the complete collections, but the Uncanny Omar recently announced that he is going to get a reprint. Even if they are changing the title slightly to Jessica Jones, that is still an omnibus that I need to have on my shelf. More than anything, because of the fact that this was when Brian Michael Bendis was at his peak. Like a lot of people now only remember Bendis from the stuff that he's done at DC, but they forgot about the 10 to 15 years before that, when everything that had his name on it was just pure gold. Jessica Jones wasn't really a known commodity before this, and there wasn't a lot of confidence in her having her own series. This isn't primarily a superhero story, it's more detective investigation, and obviously you get to learn more about the psychology of Jessica Jones. It goes to some really dark places, so I can't really recommend it for anybody that's too young. I think I was about 15 when I first read it, and it was only really when I read it again just before the release of the Netflix show that I really understood why people love this story so much. The art as well is something that really grew on me as I kept reading this book, and it's hard to find a series that remained as consistently good as this did. And that leaves us with number one, my favorite one and done omnibus from Marvel Comics of all time. By all time, I mean the ones that I've got on my shelf and that I've actually read. The observant eye has probably seen that I've already just moved it from behind me because of course it is Astonishing X-Men. I know that we're now learning about how horrible of a person that Joss Whedon is, and I'm not really using this to make light of that, but I can't deny just how much this omnibus means to me. This and Captain America by Ed Brubaker were the first omnibuses that I ever bought, and they made me fall in love with the format. And as well, this probably is my favorite X-Men run of all time, and I know that everybody's going to have their different opinions, and again, it could just be nostalgia. Your favorite might be Uncanny X-Men, and that's great, like I enjoy what I've read of that, but for me, this is more accessible to me, and it was the first X-Men story that I ever read. Even though there were sometimes massive breaks between the single issues getting published, the art from John Cassidy just stays top tier at all times. And because of that, it does feel like it's set apart from the main continuity of the Marvel Universe, and I know that some people will argue that for some of those middle stories you need a little bit of background knowledge about the X-Men and the X-Men characters. For me, this was the first comics that I read for this team. I did okay with it, and I managed to continue reading X-Men, so it must have done something special, and even when I flick through it now, there's just so many great memories from this book. Colossus is my favourite member of the X-Men family, and this really features him front and centre as the story gets a bit later on. It's got a great Wolverine, a great Cyclops, a great Emma Frost, it's got a great Professor Xavier. It doesn't really do too much wrong for me with this book. And like I said, I know that some people do dislike this, but that's power to you. Like, I'm not going to sell this just because you don't like it. This is always going to have a special place for me, so of course it's going to make it to the top of this list. I can't see any other book that I think of more fondly for this that's just all housed under one hardcover. So that's my list, and hopefully you found this quite enjoyable, and admittedly this was more difficult than I thought it would be. I'd love to do lists like this for DC Comics. If that's something that you're interested in, let me know down below. If you didn't think that and you thought this was a list that nobody really needed to hear about, well, let me know in the comments section. I've got quite a thick skin. But if you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up, and if you didn't like it, why did you get this far? Like I said before, I've got my social media links down below along with my Amazon affiliate links. If you're not sick of the sound of my voice already, I've got some other videos here that you might wish to check out. But until next time, just make sure that you stay safe, stay reading the best books that you can find, and stay mad, all you dogs. Woof woof, see you at the next video.